And welcome to Microsoft Virtual Academy. I'm Brandon Matherson, and I'm a product marketing manager with Microsoft on the Windows Server System Center and Azure Data Center Solutions team, focused on solutions that help customers deliver more efficient services and solutions to their enterprise through IT. So far, we've been discussing automation and self-service. In this particular session, we want to focus on integration using Orchestrator and how do we think about Orchestrator as a pipeline into the other components that we're using to manage our infrastructure layer and manage our services with through the System Center 2012 R2 stack. So let's dive into what is the concept or what is the idea of how we think about integration and what tool sets and mechanisms do we provide to customers as they think about implementing our solution. A consistent platform for data center management is all about a couple of things, and it's some challenges that customers have brought to us and that we want to make sure that we address in terms of delivering an integrated solution. One is, how does data flow from system to system or across databases or across environments? That's something that customers are and that data centers are being challenged with today. How do those different components touch each other, whether it be the same suite of products or differing suite of products? Are processes supported across the business units and the systems themselves? And are there error-prone manual tasks that exist today when we think about integration? And does it inhibit automation from occurring? Maybe it does, maybe it doesn't. But those are some of the things we need to think about when we bring together an integration solution and meet some of the needs that we're seeing in the marketplace today. So the value of this consistent management platform, when we think about how System Center provides that management layer over the infrastructure, is a centralized CMDB for a shared data across all of our System Center components. We're starting to think about how do we move data from one component to the next, because we're thinking about them in terms of scenarios and things that we want to deliver in terms of provisioning that infrastructure with Virtual Machine Manager or monitoring that infrastructure with Operations Manager. And then telling the rest of the suite in terms of what are the policies, what are the processes, or the people's steps that need to occur next within that environment. We want a predictable application service levels with 360-degree monitoring. That's something that's important and giving us deep insight into our application layer. We want to optimize the application's use within the data center, whether it be for hoster scenarios or whether it be the capacity that we need to manage as well. And then we want to make sure that we definitely meet the needs of extending our access and our management capabilities across other platforms. So that's something that we've thought about and we brought into our story and want to make sure that we deliver moving forward. We have our Orchestrator toolkit, and this is really key in terms of thinking about integration. And so one of the things that I want to think about is our integration pack wizard. And that's a big attribute that we're delivering with Orchestrator, which helps us to be able to identify in a way what are the integration packs that we need to bring in, what is their status, what are the dependent files that are in this environment that we need to bring in as well to make sure that we have seamless management and we don't have a disconnect between these different components. The other is, we also provide a command line activity wizard as well, where if you operate best in a Windows PowerShell-based environment, we can take advantage of your skill set there as well and provide some scripting and tool sets there. We also have .NET integration pack as well, which is a big one for our developers. So we want to make sure that we bring those capabilities into Orchestrator, that it enables us to connect to existing investments that you have in your environment today. So integration across the infrastructure, what does this look like? First, let's take a look at Orchestrator. Orchestrator is where we have the key piece to connect to each of our components within the enterprise, as well as third-party assets as well. So Orchestrator touches Service Manager, and this is where I think about the runbooks that I have in Orchestrator, as well as the data that I need to bring into the CMDB. And the data bus is what's going to be very helpful in helping us to be able to achieve this capability. So I have bidirectional connector that brings information in between those two points, between the runbooks and between the CMDB. Next, I have all of my suite of products, right? I have components that exist within System Center as well as my workloads and my third-party management tools that go into Orchestrator or that come into Service Manager as well. I then have automation commands that I'm now distributing to System Center through our third-party tools, and now with Exchange, Azure, as well as even SharePoint and with our Orchestrator SharePoint integration pack. I then have inbound data that I'm going to be bringing in for the use of notifications. Think notification from the perspective of I need to know what the status is of a given process, of a given activity that's occurring within my environment. I'm then passing that information on to the Service Manager Data Warehouse, which you'll see there on the right. This is where I've captured information, usage information, performance information, service information, and now I can deliver that in terms of reports. And reporting is where the insights help us make better decisions within the environment. I don't want us to also forget about our integration with Operations Manager and that we're actually able to monitor Orchestrator runbooks, and we're able to get information about that within the Operations Manager console that is in terms of the infrastructure and roles, the services, events that may be occurring. This information is all gathered through what's called management packs, and we'll bring in management packs across the suite that helps us integrate and be able to manage tasks and activities within those other components. We also have a custom management pack for runbook monitoring. And this is where I'm able to monitor the job history, the queue. I want to know real-time information around how am I performing. And you'll see a dashboard that's similar to this. That's what you see on the screen in terms of where I'm seeing performance, where I'm seeing growth, where I'm seeing potential thresholds being met. And I can look at a number of different attributes within that monitoring, and that's why this called the Orchestrator Overview, is where I can gather all that information moving forward. So the Service Manager and Orchestrator integration piece is where what is really key in terms of bringing the policies, processes together with the actual runbooks and execution of systems that needs to occur. I have some action requests. I need to collect that information. I need to validate that information. I need to record it, hence the CMDB. I then need to execute on those steps, and that's what's done within Orchestrator itself. So that process is really how we see it moving throughout the cycle or throughout the workflow that you may have within your environment. Now, integration packs are, as we've been talking about, helps us be able to manage tasks and processes across multiple clouds. Within our CloudOS vision, we see the data center as expanding boundaries. It's no longer just in one place. We take advantage of assets as they may exist in multiple locations. That can be on-premises or our private cloud, that's Windows Server plus System Center. Or it may be our public cloud, which is Windows Azure. Or even your service provider environments, and that may be a mixed environment that they may be using within their own solution or their proprietary solution that we can now bring extensibility into the story. So out of the box, you're going to get access to all of the System Center components. You're also going to get Active Directory, Exchange, both the user and the admin components. You're going to take advantage of, we have some tool sets with IBM, HP, even VMware. And then we also have Windows Azure and SharePoint as well. So within R2, we're going to see kind of those top level ones that are really exciting for us to expand into managing our workloads even better. Microsoft workloads run best on the Microsoft platform. And so we're taking advantage of that connectivity or that integration with Exchange, with SharePoint, with Windows Azure, expanding out into managing those environments in the cloud. Now, we also have partner-enabled IPs, which are also brought into the story as well. And this is where we take advantage of things that they've built that are supported. Now, some of these do have additional costs associated with them, but these are also very, very effective for you to manage those environments that you may have. BMC, NetApp, Cisco, Vision Solutions, Kelvarian are some to name a few. And then we have some others that are in CodePlace that are not formally supported, but are provided through the community, the Microsoft community, to provide a broader breadth of solutions which you can bring in to manage and integrate into Orchestrator, into your System Center suite for better management of your stack. So some of these standard activities that you'll see are kind of some of the system functions, scheduling and monitoring, file management, email notification, event logging, utilities, even runbook control. And why do I care about these things? Because I want to make sure that I'm able to deliver a broad set of activities or tasks that I want to be able to do across a varying subset of technologies, from running programs, or I want to ensure that my SQL databases have connectivity, or my file system in Windows. I want to make sure that that's up and running and that's available. So I want to make sure that that is there. Let's take a quick look. I just want to show in Orchestrator where you can expect to see these runbooks and what you can expect to see in terms of the integration packs. So I'm going to go over to Orchestrator to take a look at the runbook designer console and where you'll be able to click on each of the necessary runbooks. So let's take a look. I have my console up and running. And you'll notice, again, I have a number of runbooks on the left-hand side, but on the right side are where all my activities lie. And within those activities, you'll see a number of categories. You'll see some standardized categories up here towards the top, MS SQL, execute PowerShell script, text manipulation. You'll notice our Windows Azure integration. And now I can think about connecting to activities for Windows Azure, doing Azure deployments or Azure Cloud Services. I want to think about storage. I want to perform some tasks in storage and virtual machines that may exist in Azure. I also have, at the bottom here, you'll notice some of my System Center components, Configuration Manager, Operations Manager, Service Manager, Virtual Machine Manager, as well as third-party tools such as VMware. HP is another to name some, BMC. So they're all here in which we've brought in, and you can download these on the Download Center, and you can bring these on as Orchestrator add-ons and extensions. And we have these available for R2, are now available for you to start installing and playing with within your environment. But what does it look like when I'm actually in one of these consoles? For instance, if I'm in Service Manager, you'll notice I have a number of different commands that I can bring in between create change with the template. I can create an incident with the template. And I've used it in this particular runbook. So in my incident management runbook, I have a service management set of tasks. And then I have a runbook that's called incident management. And I have a task here where I'm actually taking advantage of the service manager incident, where I want to bring in an incident template. And you'll notice that I have this attributes that I can see about the template, about the object itself. I class it as an incident. I have identified or labeled the incident template as software issue incident template. You'll have a number of information about the fields that are associated with this particular with this particular object, all brought in through the flexibility with the integration pack. As another tool, perhaps I want to look at VM management. Here's another one that I've created. I have a Git VM template where I'm actually going to bring in integration with Virtual Machine Manager. And I can grasp more information about what that looks like by opening this up here, and I can see I'm connected directly to the 2012 Virtual Machine Manager object here. And that's brought to me through the integration with Virtual Machine Manager, as you see here. I click on that and I can select different objects within my template itself. And it's a basic drag and drop process that we would apply to an open canvas that we may have available to be able to start to create this runbook. And as you notice, when you do this, to inhibit breaking down or breaking some process that I may have in production, I want to make sure that I check this out. And you'll notice I tried to drag and drop that in there, and it said, do you want to check out this runbook? Yes, I do, because I don't want to inhibit an existing running process that's already in my environment and cause problems with my infrastructure today. So I want to make sure that I check that out, and I'm able to do that as I play with a given runbook. Another feature, another attribute here is that I have runbook tester, which enables me to be able to test a runbook that I'm starting to play with and put together. You'll notice I'm going from initiate a VM repair. I want to go call and identify that VM, and then I want to go physically repair that VM and perform some tasks on it to ensure that that VM is up and running in case an issue has come up or a problem has occurred. So I would click on runbook tester, and again, it looks like it's still processing the checkout of this particular runbook. I then want to make sure that I can go ahead and perform those tasks, run through it. It'll tell me where I fail, and I can debug it right here within this console, within a window that pops up in this console, and be able to perform those tasks. So that's how I will perform, take advantage of the integration packs that are within Orchestrator for all of my System Center components, third-party tools, and some Windows Server and Windows Azure components as well. So let me go back to my slides, and I will continue to talk about how do these integration packs provide more flexibility, and what tasks can I perform with them today. All right, so as we just talked about a number of the actual integration packs that we see today, we have the Windows Azure Pack, the Azure Integration Pack. And then this one is going to help enable us to perform more tasks in the public cloud space, where I can add a layer of management and manage some VMs and perform some tasks that may exist in that cloud. And it's the connectivity with Orchestrator and Service Manager to be able to provide me the ability to be able to do that. Some of the things that I can do, I have the Azure Cloud Services, I can do Azure deployments, I can manage Azure storage, the VMs themselves, the images, and a number of other tasks that are brought in that total up to approximately 60 or so activities that you now have the ability to be able to manage with this pack. From a workload perspective, we have Exchange and SharePoint, where I have integration packs for Microsoft Exchange, where I think about both the user and the admin perspective, as well as SharePoint. And I want to think about monitoring a mailbox or managing documents and lists and building out queries. The community has built out through some integration packs as well, through managing Exchange Mail as well and Exchange Management. So we want to make sure that you're able to look at all the scenarios that you may want to leverage to be able to do that. When we think about partners, a list of partners that we provide integration packs for, and the scenarios where they may want to do that, alert forwarding, auto generation, VM provisioning in some cases may be some of the activities that we may want to perform. Let's not forget about REST, or representational state transfer, is where this is a big activity where we want to invoke a REST service. And we have a number of different tools where we can enable this through web services to provide the ability to build this into your workflows, into your activities that you're going to be building. And it provides more flexibility for Orchestrator and expand and management tasks that you can do within IT. There's also the Cloud Services Process Pack, and this is something that we bring into Service Manager, where we actually think about there are both components that are brought into Service Manager as well as Orchestrator runbooks. And we have a number of runbooks that we're leveraging and workflows that come with the CSPP. This is an additional download that is brought in through Download Manager, Download Center on Microsoft.com. And it provides model extensions where I want to think about managing capacity. I want to think about my logical networks, placement tags. I have a number of templates, request templates that it brings in, a number of request offerings that it also brings in, as well on top of all the runbooks that are brought into Orchestrator. So this is just something that I plug on to take advantage of managing my private cloud infrastructure in addition to what I already have out of the box with Service Manager and Orchestrator. So if I think about cross-platform deployments and what Orchestrator can do there, is now we're starting to take advantage of third-party integration packs that allows me to be able to kick off some commands and take advantage of, in this case, Operations Manager, where I want to, I'm waiting for an alert and I want to kick off that alert before some tasks, because I want to then know what alerts are coming up in Ops Manager and send that off to Service Manager. And then I will call for a number of different activities and then forward those alerts onto the necessary environments or necessary tasks that I want to perform. So that's basically how I can see the integration packs and the integration story within System Center 2012R2 Orchestrator, bringing to life a number of the activities. This kind of sums up the entire automation self-service story, all the way from self-service for the cloud tenant, system automation with Orchestrator, process automation using the investments with Service Manager and Orchestrator, and then the integration with Orchestrator out to the rest of the System Center stack, as well as third-party tools. So I really appreciate your time and walking through this session on automation and self-service. It's been a pleasure to provide some more insight to you as you take this information. Following this presentation, we have additional slides in the appendix that you can learn more about the integration story, more about the automation story, more about the self-service. And we would love for you to go into TechNet, into the Download Center, and get your hands on System Center 2012R2 and Service Manager and Orchestrator and download it and start playing with it within your environment. We also encourage you to go check out our virtual labs that we've created on TechNet. We have a number of labs and some specific scenarios that we've created to give you step-by-step guidance into how to set some of these unique tasks up. Some of them more complex, some of them less complex, according to your needs. And of course, continue to come back to learn more from Microsoft Virtual Academy in terms of the System Center 2012 R2 capabilities and a number of the different sessions that we have. I'll also be doing the IT Service Management, which builds on the processes that we've had for Service Manager, and we welcome you at any time. Thanks again. My name is Brandon Matherson.